Hello folks, happy new year. I hope the slides are visible. I'll good. So let's get started. This talk is mainly about context managers. Just a few glitches. So I'm Pradhan. I am a Python enthusiast. I currently work at ScrollStack. I love all things open source and especially communities around open source. I go by Pradhan everywhere, IRC or any social media platform. So let's get started. Most of the Python programmers must have either knowingly or unknowingly have dealt with context managers. Python provides such ease of using abstraction that most of the time we overlook clever features, thinking it's a bit trivial abstraction. Context managers are no exception in that case. If you look in the Python docs, this is the definition you would find for a context manager. A context manager is an object that defines the runtime context to be established when executing a which statement. To be honest, that is quite a lot for anyone to understand, especially if it's he or she or they is a beginner, right? So to simplify things down, context manager are objects that help with control flow of the which statement. Let's see an example that most of you folks must have definitely used at some point. The open function is a classic example of a context manager with the control flow of with as. So here what is being done is a temp context is being set and the open function is returning an IO object here f, and something is done in the with block. Here we are using that f variable to write to a file, and when the context manager flow is exited, and this temp context is reliably closed. And if you've done some testing or somewhat like, it's like a setup and tear down process. So first thing that comes to my mind while reading this code is, can't I use a try finally block instead of doing this? So what's the fuss all about, right? Well, technically we can use the whole statement try except finally, where finally would close the file. And in the try part, you would open the file. But then you would be defeating the whole purpose of a context manager. The which statement was designed to simplify the try finally pattern, and the prep for context manager exists just so we can control the flow of which statement. Besides that, context manager help in closing resources reliably, so you don't have to manually manage either the connection or the resource and check every time, is it being closed reliably? Is the connection closed? Is the file closed? And stuff like that. It also helps in improving readability of the code, since most of the things are abstracted with a single with as control flow. So let's come back to a file example and take a bit of a deeper dive to see what the with as control flow and how it's being executed. So the with statement, if you'd see here, is always run with an expression. Here is an open function which returns a variable, here f, and this variable's value is associated with the result of this open function. So in the with block, some work is done. Here, that variable f is used to write a file. And when the whole with block continues forward and exited, the control flow exits, and either the resource that was being used is released or a previous state is being restored when the whole context manager changes or moves ahead of the control flow. Now that we have some basic idea of what context managers are and why do they even exist in the Python ecosystem, let's try to answer these three questions moving forward in this talk. How does a context manager actually work? Can I write my own? And most importantly, if it's that important, does the standard library has a module for it already? Let's tackle the first two questions here. The file manager class tries to mimic that open function which we saw earlier and exposes the two major dunder methods, enter and exit, which are responsible for creating the temp context, doing the work, and restoring the state of an object. So when a context manager is called, here the file manager is called with some file and a mode, the value, the dunder enter method is called with just a self, with just self as an argument, right? And inside that enter method, an IO object is returned. So this self.open file is the value that is associated with F, where so later on this variable F can be used to do some work. Here it's writing to a file, and when the whole control flow exits this with block, the dunder exit is called with three other arguments besides self: exception, exception type, and exception traceback. And by the time you have realized, this exit method is checking for exceptions. If the dunder exit on successful exit of a dunder exit, all three arguments must have a value none. That's how the context manager's exit method realizes that no exception has been raised. For some reason, let's say if you want to suppress those exceptions, in the exit method, you can just return a true here. The return true would just say that, hey, no exception has been raised, even though if an exception has been raised or not. Now, the previous example was somewhat of a toy example. Now let's look into somewhat of a real world example that we can use by creating a database handler for Postgres. The enter method here is used to make the connection for the to the database and returns a cursor object, which we can use to either provide SQL commands to it, and it would implement those. The exit method here checks for exception, raises if any, and closes the connection reliably. So here, now this database handler can be used anywhere in the program, and we don't have to worry much about opening and closing a file or even managing exceptions. If you see here, this is more readable compared to the whole try except finally block. So the editor class has two major functions: get article and add journalist, which do a very basic CRUD job. The get article fetches articles based on a particular start and end date, and add journalists, basically editors can add journalists to the CMS or something like that. Moving on, the decimal object here, the decimal module in the standard library has a function called local context. This local context can be used as a context manager, and this context manager helps in doing some very high precision calculations, right? If you can see the width block, I'm doing some decimal precision calculation up to 42 places where like high precision arithmetic function is called. And when the whole flow exits, this context manager, local context, restores the precision back to what it was originally set to. Clever, isn't it? I really found it interesting. So till now we've answered two out of three questions that we are seeking answers for. How does the context manager work? And can I write my own? Now let's move our focus to the standard library module named ContextLib, which lets you build context managers with the help of a decorator or context manager. So the context manager converts your generator functions. You can tell in a very layman term, if I had to explain generators, and it a function that yields can be termed as a decorator. Generator. So the context manager decorator converts those generator functions into context managers so that it can be used in a with as control flow. Here, foobar can be used in a with as control flow, and foobar is a context manager now with the with statement. So, and that yield is used to split the function. Like when everything before the yield, here print before, will be executed at the beginning of the block. Anything after the yield, here print after, would be called at the end of the with block. And yield the returns an empty dictionary, which would be the value of FB. So if you print FB, the whole output would be before, empty dictionary, and after. So it's a simple context manager, right? Nothing much fuss. But since we know that every context manager has a dunder enter and enter exit, let's see how it's being tackled through ContextLib. Even though you can't see the enter and exit method behind all this abstraction, under the hood they are being called. Enter is called before the yield, exit after the yield. And how do I know so? Because I checked the module's source code. So let's get started with the enter method. This is the actual code block of the ContextLib. I have linked the CPython code here. So it's a very small function. And since it's a generator function, its major job is to yield the value of the generator object, here self.gen, and returns the yielded value so that it can be assigned as a value of as in the with as block. Right? Now, let's look into the exit dunder. Just to keep in mind, the code block was very well commented out in the CPython GitHub repo. So I've removed all those comments to fit the code block in one screen. If you go to the link, you would find this exact code block, but with a very well documented comments. Okay. So the exit method here checks for exceptions. You see this type, right? So if anything is passed to the type besides none, the self.gen throw would be called, which is used to call exception. And it would raise an exception in the yield line. So it would raise an exception here. And otherwise, if no exception is being raised, all three values return a none. And it's the next dot gen is called, which is just a way of saying move ahead with the generator function. Now let's convert that database handler example with ContextLib and with a decorator based context manager. So anything before the yield is being used to make a connection to Postgres. Anything after the yield is used to reliably close down that connection, and yield returns a cursor object, which is the value associated after as here db. db value would be the cursor object, and you can use that db to execute various SQL queries. The code snippet would work very nice in a happy flow if you don't get an exception. But if you get an exception, this program is seriously flawed, because we remember that the exit method raises an exception in the yield part if it gets any. And since we don't have an exception handling here, the generator function will abort if it gets any exception without closing the resource properly. Here, resource being the connection that it's making. So it's failing the very single job that it was meant for, right? So how do we tackle exceptions? So by default, the decorator-based context manager's exit method suppresses the exception. So to do that, if you want to raise an exception, we would need to explicitly re-raise in a decorator function. So quoting Luciano Ramello here, having a try finally around the yield is an unavoidable price of using a decorator-based context manager, because you never know what the users of a context manager are going to do inside their web block. So this is an updated code, updated example with simply a try except finally, to so that we can catch or re-raise exceptions, right? If you get any exception here, we can easily log it and finally would eventually close the connection reliably with proper exception handling. Now that we've covered the core areas of context manager and have answered all the major questions that we were seeking in the starting of the doc. How does a context manager work? Can I write my own? And writing a context manager with the help of a standard lib module. Coming to the last section of the talk called PyRandom, I've created some small examples which I found very interesting while reading more about context managers. So first, if you use multiple context manager or nest them, it would work in a LIFO or last in first out manner. So the enter method that is called the last here, C's enter method is called the last, would exit first, right? Moving to the second snippet, this might be a bit obvious to most of the folks who know what generators are and what they do. So generator based context managers are single use. What I meant by that, if you create an instance and use it as a context manager, you can use it only once. If you use it multiple times, it would throw out an error saying something like runtime error, generator didn't yield. Basically saying that you can use only once with the instance of that generator. So similarly, most context managers that deal with resources are single use anyway, because it doesn't make sense to reopen a file that is being handled once or closed, nor does it make sense to open an already open file with the same instance of a context manager that was used earlier to handle files. Besides single use context manager, there are two other context managers that you should be on a lookout for. This, they might seem a bit confusing or similar, but let's look into them. The first one is called a recurrent context manager. It's a context manager that can be nested with multiple with statement, and unlike single use context manager, uses the same instance of a context manager in that nested with block. Whereas a reusable context manager cannot be nested with multiple with as statements, but their single instance can be used multiple times. What I actually mean, you can see in the examples next. If you see redirect.stdout is a perfect example of a recurrent context manager. Here we create an instance write to stream. Write to stream can be used in a multiple with statement. And if you notice, it's using the same instance Okay. But and lock in the threading module is a classic example of a reusable context manager. Its single instance can be used multiple times, but if you try to nest it, you would face a deadlock. Okay. So that's it, folks. That's the end of my random, the last section of my talk. And I would like to give credit where it's due. This talk is heavily inspired from the notes that I took some 2 years back while reading Fluent Python book by Luciano and obviously Python Docs. Now the artwork and icons that you see are from FlatIcon. Thanks. I'm happy to take any questions.
Sure, let's wait for some time and we'll see if there are any questions. If you have any question, please post it in the YouTube live chat. People are appreciating your talk.
Thanks, folks.
Okay. There is one question. I will relay it to you. You can see my screen, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so Shinto asks real life use cases other than database connections.
Anywhere where you need to do some work, let's say if you want to call a function and you want to do some work before it and after it, that can be done with a context manager. Also, if you look, I was reading something on the book and it mentioned David Beasley's book where he tried to do a simple lazy connection object with a context manager. So you can probably look into that too. I hope I answered the question.
Oh, so Abhijit is saying he has used the this way of doing basically the context manager to enable and disable profiling. I read that comment before, but later realized what he is actually saying. Nice.
So some people say that it's very similar to decorators, because in a decorator also you are doing something before it, before the function, and some doing something after the functions. So I guess it's just a matter of a taste, I guess, if you use a decorator or you use a context manager.
Okay, there is another question, or did you answer that? I don't know. I'll just paste it here. Just a minute. Now you might be able to see it properly. Yep.
I agree with Manav. I also find it a bit easier to write my own class with Dunder Exit and Dunder than using the whole context manager.
That's it, I guess. No, wait. There is another one. This is nice. Can I use it as setup and tear down in PyTest framework?
I haven't, to be honest, done that, but you can, since you are doing setup and teardown is also a similar thing, right? You do something before the function call or anything you are being called, and you tear down that exact process or the state to its original state in the teardown part. So I guess you can use it. I haven't, so I need to check on that.
Okay.
Also, context managers are heavily used if when dealing with threading module, so you don't have to manually acquire a lock and then release it. It's a efficient way of writing, I guess.
There is another one. What are the operations where we cannot use decorators and can use context manager?
We cannot do and can use as of I can't think of anything because both methods with a decorator and a context manager, you can try to do a similar thing. But let me read up on it. I'll ping up on Twitter or something. I'll add it.
Yeah, you can basically post that on the this
I
thing.
all the issue
GitHub
I'll
issue.
yeah I'll post that on the GitHub issue if I find something very interesting about it.
Cool. That's it, I guess. Thank you, Pradhan, for your talk.
Thanks for having me, folks.